Did you know that spending too much time together is a leading cause for divorce? Just kidding, I made that up right now. But like, based on some news articles that I've been reading, it's definitely believable. I think couples are starting to feel the heat of like spending basically 24 hours a day like with each other, just kind of trapped inside together. So today, we're going to share some helpful hints for surviving quarantine as a married couple or a couple that's living together. Surviving quarantine as a married couple. It's like when you think about it, you're in your normal daily schedule. If you're living together, you spend like maybe 2 hours in the morning together and like a couple hours at night. The majority of your day is spent like at work for like at least 8 or 9 hours and then sleeping for like hopefully 7 to 8 hours. So you're not really actually spending that much time together, but like now it's just us 24/7 and like it's just us.
I love it. You're having the best time.
Yeah, I love it too. So fortunately, because I used to be a freelancer and I worked from home a lot, and he's a graduate student, so like his schedule is very flexible. He can work in the lab or at home, depending, most times. So like we're pretty used to it, so I think we had that at least advantage. But because we're used to it, we also have some advice and tips for other couples who are experiencing it for the very first time and finding it to be a struggle. So number one, you should both have your daily schedule set in your head. Kyuho likes to sleep in, I hate sleeping in. In the past, I might have felt like I wanted my schedule to sync up with his, so that's something very tempting. Like when you first got trapped up with your significant other, you probably had this like brief little honeymoon phase, like, oh yeah, we're gonna do everything together, we're gonna have sex all day, whatever, but like that's obviously not, that doesn't last, and like you have to keep your separate schedules. So, like, he's comfortable sleeping till like 8 or 9 a.m. but I'm up at like 6, 7 a.m. I go straight to work. No ifs, ands, or buts. That keeps me like going and like productive.
I find the most productive time for me, and it's in many times like a very late night. So I tend to stay up late and work like 2 hours or longer, very focused. And sleep a little more, like in the morning.
Yeah. But like I'll go to bed when he starts working, and so it gives us like some room to breathe, and like it gives us like our own focus zones. Like I know I have a good solid 2 hours in the morning without him, like even in my mind, because he'll be asleep and I can like get my work done. One thing that's really good is to exercise together. We try to exercise in the house, and
for me it works great again. I think I love just being at home. So I just walk inside the house and get like a 6,000, 7,000 steps, and I do my push-up in the room. Yeah.
At first, like I didn't really like that idea. Like I like to walk outside, but I started trying it, and so now it's like,
oh, she's crazy. She does like hot yoga. No, what was it? Hot Zumba?
Yeah. Like she's I did like Latin dance.
Yeah.
Like
actually her legs got stronger, very healthy. Yeah, even healthier.
Yeah, so we exercise inside together, and like it's good hearing and seeing each other exercise, because it makes us more conscious of like what the other is doing to stay like productive and healthy, and like there's something really sexy about that. Like, so if you want to like reignite the spark after the honeymoon phase dies out, exercise together. Yeah. Trust us, we've been married 2.5 years, been together 5 years. Anyway, or like you don't have to exercise together, like do couple yoga or whatever, but like exercise in front of each other. You know what I mean?
I think so. It
watching
works.
Me do those squats. Ooh, ooh. Anyway, what else? Oh, when you do things together, like schedule things to do together. It's really tempting, because you're just with each other all day, to just have like these fluid lines of like work, play, and like just go and touch each other or whatever whenever you want. But I think it's better if you kind of schedule quality time. Even during the day when we're both awake, we kind of like keep to ourselves. Like, I mean, it's hard because we live in a small apartment, but we kind of just focus on our own thing, and then we'll be like, okay, what time do you want to watch a movie together? A tip would be like schedule a time to watch a movie together. So that way we're like, okay, usually for us it's usually after dinner, so like around 6 or 7 p.m. we're gonna Netflix and chill. So up until that time, aside from like meal time, up until that time, our day is ours and we spend it how we want to. Like, I'm focused on my work, he's focused on his work. Sometimes we film a YouTube video together or whatever, but other than that, we're not really like in each other's space too much. And so that at least gives you the illusion of like having free time.
It's very tempting, like I love her and like sometimes she looks like unexpectedly sexy and I want her so badly, but she kind of calms me down and like it's work time.
Yeah, we gotta work, yeah.
And yeah, I gotta wait.
Yeah.
But yeah, it's very tempting, so you should really keep her advice in mind.
Yeah. If you don't have boundaries, imagine if you're trying to like read a book or like do your work and your spouse or whoever just comes over and they're like, hey, like you want to have sex right now? It would be like, I don't know, it may be different for other people, but I'd be like, I'm busy. But like, you don't want to say that because like that will start a fight. So like, it's better from the beginning, you just schedule your separate and like schedule together time and then have your separate focus time. It's been a month, but I feel like we have still a long time to go. So pace yourselves.
Pace yours.
Yeah. You can easily get bored with each other.
We had a big whiteboard and wrote down what we are gonna do.
Like a goal board.
Goal board. I called it war board.
Oh yeah.
Yeah, and surprisingly, yeah, I finished almost all of them. And it really helps to keep your work like being done.
Yeah. If you're in quarantine, your main focus may just be surviving. And so you don't feel pressured like you have to be as productive as everyone else. But like, yeah, it worked for us because like my way of not stressing out is, I guess, like focusing more on work, I think. So yeah, it worked for us having a war board or scoreboard or whatever. We each had our separate goals and we like check them off as we go along. It's like a fun challenge as long as you don't take it too seriously. Since you're both home together, there's no more excuses. Split up your chores. Make sure you take turns cooking dinner, take turns cleaning. Kyuho usually used to cook a lot, but now, like, since I have the time and I'm here, I'm helping out a lot more with that. Like, I'm doing breakfast, sometimes lunch.
Oh, yeah, that's actually cool. And you might find your hidden talent. I'm, like, surprised almost every time she makes something.
Because
she makes something the way that I never even expected.
Oof.
And sometimes you find, like, little innovation in the simple food, like pasta, pizza. It can be really exciting.
Which leads me to my final helpful hint, which is to just start experimenting with things. Like, you have a shit ton of free time right now. If you can, don't waste it. If you're someone who doesn't normally cook, give it a try, or try baking, or like try painting, get into writing. Like, do whatever you can to just express your emotions and creativity in like a good and productive way. And that way you won't be like harassing your significant other. So right now I'm also writing again, and so that's my way of like channeling all this confusion and energy and like frustration. The most important ones are keep your separate times and schedule together time. If you have any other helpful hints, let us know, please. The most important thing is to maintain your health and safety. Adjacent to that, or maybe like a step below, is maintaining your sanity and like your close relationships. So anyway, hope that helps and good luck. Thank you so much, and bye.
Bye.